If I had my time again, I would do it all the same. And I'd change a single thing, even when I was the blame for the heartache and the pain that I caused throughout my years. How I learned to be a man through the laughter and the tears. Situation no win, rush for a change of atmosphere. I can't go on, so I give in. Gotta get myself right out of here.
Hi, welcome to the Naz Underground. This is our first show of 1993. Happy New Year. Today we have a very special treat for you. We have Beth Lyons, a dancer, and we have last year's host and producer from X-Ray Vision. So stay tuned.
High radon levels will expose your family to as much radiation as having hundreds of chest x-rays in 1 year. Call to get your radon test information.
Hi, welcome back to Naz Underground. We have our first guest here with us today. They're the host and producer of last year's show, X-Ray Vision, Ed Marecki and Mac Middleton. Could you tell us a little bit about last year's show?
Well,
what do you want to know?
Yeah.
How did it work? Did everything that you put into it come out the way you wanted it to come out?
No. Well, they're waving to us. We had our problems, like every, you know, like I'm sure you guys have problems. We tried to work them out the best we can, sometimes with arguments.
We were just very, very inexperienced. I mean,
yeah.
Like, very laid back.
Yes.
And so what you brought.
Well, I don't know, everyone was like new. It was like the first time we've ever done TV before, so yeah. We had our own technical difficulties.
Well, we did have that one guy that was an extra.
True. Very true.
True.
Oh, he's a professional actor.
Professional.
I guess. He was in Ferris Bueller's Day Off or something. Yeah.
Aren't you a professional actor?
I am professional. I would
recommend. You could ask him about the professional actor.
But I think that we got across what we tried, we wanted to do. We wanted to expose a different side of Nazareth.
That we did, and we did.
We had people like Randall Dean on.
Star Trek fanatic. Connoisseur.
We had the girls' basketball team.
And which can God. I say that I predicted they would win the championship, and doggone it, they did.
I mean, still nobody knows like what the girls' basketball team is. We had them on.
We had some chick that was stuck somewhere, didn't we?
We had a lot of people. We just had a lot of people on. It's really cool.
Yeah, we did.
So
yeah.
You think you're successful?
Yeah, we did. Our last show I thought was very good too, with Mike Skalski playing guitar.
It was. It was good.
It was an excellent. I thought we had an excellent.
We had a lot of live performances. A lot of
Gross Notion.
Yeah.
Very good band.
We had that one chick who danced, Irish dancing.
Yeah.
We had Mr. Casella do those.
We had Mike Skalski play guitar. We had Gross Notion. Now you're up to five.
Yeah, we had Michelle Leza come on too. With her cannolis or whatever the hell.
Yeah.
But I guess it's enough.
We had a whole hell of a lot of things going
hell,
on.
You said hell.
You said crap before.
That's not in a take. I didn't say crap because it's not on the take.
There were things, I don't know, we felt good. I felt good personally about what we were doing.
I usually sick to my stomach after every show.
Because you were so excited.
It was a lot of fun. It was fun, and that's what we thought.
I can speak for the entire group last year. I thought we did too.
That's what I felt as producer. That was the most important thing. It was a extracurricular activity at school.
And not sports. We didn't concentrate on sports. But you know, we didn't because
everyone does sports. You know, we thought TV would be different.
You know, and
the primary goal we thought was
you're sitting on top of me.
I know, but that's all right.
Okay.
It was supposed to be fun, and I think that everybody had fun. It was a good time.
Karen, did you have fun? Karen was on the show last year. Did you have fun last year, Karen?
I always had fun.
And you, all these guys were here, except for you.
Marianne
Mac wants me to ask you about your professional acting.
I told you not to do that.
I'm sorry. Tell him about your professional acting.
I work for a group called SST Communications doing intervention theater, and I traveled all over the Midwest.
Wait,
United
didn't they
States.
Come to NASA?
They did perform a show at Nazareth Academy before.
Will you be coming back?
No.
I don't believe Nazareth Academy has booked SST again for this year for their Healthy Choices Week or whatever. I don't know. I know you leave school and everything gets shot.
All hell breaks loose.
You know, everything that you try to set up, you know, they just throw it out the window and it's all gone. You come, I don't even know if they're having a Healthy Choices
Week. We don't, I don't know.
This year or not or some kind of thing.
All Catholic schools do?
I'm pretty sure.
Well, I don't go to Catholic.
But I don't believe they've invited SST Communications yet, so if they do, well, then I'm sure I'll be there.
You're both college students, correct?
Yeah, more or less.
Yeah. Yeah.
Can you tell us about where you attend and a little bit about it?
Well, I go to Southern Illinois University, the fine learning institution in Carbondale, Illinois. They accept just about anybody.
Yeah.
No, we're a good school, though. We have a lot of their very, you know, people get the wrong idea about Southern Illinois. See, they think that it's just, you know, one big party. It's not. We have a lot of smart people down there. I mean, a lot of, you know. I love Southern Illinois.
I'm glad.
I do. No, you're not glad, because you don't care. I think you're very cold.
You got me. I'm a cold person.
No.
When it comes to Southern Illinois.
Well, no, it's very nice. The weather's very nice down
there. Do you have any gum and mint or anything?
Do you want me to check?
That's right.
I could check. No, I'll check.
It's really okay.
I'm going to check for you anyway.
Does anyone in the peanut gallery have mints?
Mints, gum.
Oh, you better wipe your nose.
Mints or gum?
This is clean.
Is it clean?
Well, yeah. I only wipe my nose once or twice. But it's dry.
There's things falling out of it.
No. Not really.
So how is Nazareth Academy since whenever we left?
Yeah, when did we leave? We left in, like, May? June?
July?
No, we didn't leave. How is Nazareth?
How is Nazareth Academy?
We just want to ask you a question since you've been doing all the question asking.
Okay, it's...
How old are you?
Okay, so how... And I think Naz is doing it.
He's going to answer his first question first. You ask him one question.
What year in school are you?
I am a sophomore.
Oh, so you've been in the academy.
They know both the Mareki and the Middleton brothers.
Ooh.
I think so.
Isn't your brother a sophomore, correct?
Yeah, I have a brother who is a sophomore, yes.
And well enough about me. Back to you and your college.
Well, how is the academy?
Sister Jackie?
How is Mr.
I saw her at work the other day. Mr. Moran, I have not seen Mr. Moran in
How
ages.
Is Mr. Moran?
You know, Mr. Moran is a viewer of our show, if you want to say hi to him.
He is always, Mr. Moran loves us.
He does, yeah.
Go ahead and say hi to him.
How you doing, Mr. Moran?
Mr. Moran. We just love Nazareth Kent. We love to be on the show and...
Yeah, and I hope you're enjoying us because I feel very disciplined. I feel that you've disciplined me in a way that I can do this on television.
You're not being sarcastic, are you?
No, I'm not being sarcastic. Okay. I feel like, because Nazareth really did a lot of shaping. We're in that camera now.
I'm trying to catch up.
As opposed to the dance that he did. Is that this camera dance?
I think we're losing focus.
We're on this one now.
Okay, now, okay.
I've got something about Star Trek.
Yeah, Star Trek!
Could you tell us a little bit about it?
Star Trek rules, man. That is the best show on
television. The Next Generation.
The Next Generation, not the old ones.
Not Captain Kirk and Spock and...
No, that one's...
Captain Jean-Luc Picard.
Of the Starship Enterprise. Can you tell us a little bit about him?
No, well, I can't really. We've only seen a couple. We did see, like, that one really cool
two-part
show.
We saw one episode where they took him...
Captive.
He was a terrorist. He was doing some cool...
He was a terrorist!
Oh, when he was taking on the Borg, I think it was called?
No, it was a different one.
That was two episodes.
That was a different one. This is a brand new one.
This was like a month ago.
And they captured him with crayons.
They tortured him. They made him color.
They made him color with crayons. Well, that's what we think. We didn't actually
see. We didn't see the second part. We didn't see the second part. But they made him. They gave him. They gave him a box of Crayola crayons, and it was only the 8 color crayons.
Oh. He didn't have the pencil sharpener.
He didn't
so
have
he
the
dulled,
pencil sharpener.
And he couldn't color within the lines anymore.
You must color inside the line! You can't break me! And it was very riveting.
Riveting performance by Patrick Stewart, who plays...
He might need a Kleenex. He got a little drool there on the side.
No, really. It's all right. Where did you put your Kleenex? Oh, that's quite all right.
I think he's very afraid of us.
Are you afraid of us? When I move close to you, why do you move away?
We are
awe-inspiring. Are we invading your space?
Aren't we?
No. I'm not a space person. I don't really...
Yes, you are. You haven't taken speech class yet, have you?
No, I
haven't. Do they learn this in speech class about space things?
I think so.
Okay. You can sit right down now.
No, I don't want to.
You haven't told us about your college life yet.
College is... he was going on.
We want to hear a little bit from you.
Yeah, something's boring. Go on.
Okay.
Yeah.
I attend the University of Illinois at Chicago. And that's something I need to know, okay? And I live downtown. It's a great city, Chicago. It's great.
He's near Greek Town.
Right there, Greg. Greek Town, Belly Dancers.
Check. Damn, Belly Dancers a Greek Town?
Damn right they have Belly Dancers.
You said damn.
I said crap and I said hell too. But I'm from a Catholic school.
That's the hat trick.
Oh!
You've completed the television swear words you can say. Never mind.
One, you missed one.
Which
that
one?
That you can say on television.
We'll say it.
I'll see if you can figure it out.
Say it.
No, I want to see if you can figure it out.
Is it SOB?
No, we can't say that. Not on cable, especially. I mean, this is a school production.
Public accent.
This is a school production. We don't want to, because we could jeopardize their.
Wait, they could beep us out, you know.
Oh, they could.
You know,
let's just start swearing.
You know what? This would be one big beep.
Andy, put your finger on the button.
Okay.
Here we go.
Here we go. One. No, listen.
We better not.
Right. Would you do me a big favor and sing for us?
No.
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 We asked about Star Trek.
He did ask
about
Star Trek.
We were going to talk about that anyway.
Do a little Steve Miller for us.
He said the secret word.
What if we talk this slow? They can't hear.
I'm saying please. I'm begging.
Beg for us on your hands.
On your knees.
Boy.
We don't really need to sing that badly.
Okay, then good. We don't have to sing that badly.
All right, good.
But we'd really appreciate it.
I think you guys should sing.
I think you should.
Who asked you?
What does the peanut gallery think?
I think you guys should sing.
Come on.
Well, there's an overwhelming demand. Oh.
See, I feel like it should be warming up the mics already.
So, how many episodes have you guys? How's the show going this year? Is it?
Oh, just skip the show.
Just change the
show. This is your fifth show? Magic number five. You know what they say about the fifth show? You know what they say about it?
What?
Okay. That's great.
Yeah, that's great. I wasn't sure.
How are things
going? I didn't know where
working on the show, how is it for you?
For me, it's working pretty good.
Do you get a lot of the airtime, or does Matt Stafford get most of the airtime? I'm sorry to ask you this. I'm sorry.
I don't mean to put you on the spot, but
every show's got
to
have a
co-host. What are you trying to do here?
I'm trying to end this segment.
No, you're not.
I mean overall. What are you guys doing on the show?
We interview people,
like who?
Much like we're doing right here.
People this goofy?
Hey, Lumpy.
All right, stay tuned. Whatever camera on. We'll be back right after this message.
I think Kogan will be back.
I think we've upset him. I think.
Tony Barnes' accomplishments as a naval aviator are making his hometown proud.
I think Tony had a pretty good idea early in his life that he wanted to make a career out of the military and wanted to make something for himself.
He likes to meet new challenges and to meet new people and to go places. So, you know, he's right where he wants to be.
He knew he wanted to fly. And the Navy offered him that opportunity.
I can tell by the way, you know, he talks and he wears his uniform and everything. He really enjoys the Navy.
Well, he's proud of himself. And that shows he has a right to be proud of himself.
Each time he'd come home, you know, he was more of a man.
I think he's Navy through and through.
Tony is a great spokesman for America and for patriotism.
Whatever the people see in him, they see the Navy. And he exemplifies the best.
Tony Barnes is just one of over 500,000 people who are protecting you, representing you, making your country proud. The United States Navy, it's your Navy.
Hi, welcome back to Naz Underground. We have our second and final guest today, Beth Lyons. She's a senior at Nazareth Academy. Can you tell us a little about your school life?
I'm a senior, as you already said. I run track in the fall. Or in the spring, excuse me. And basically, that's about it.
Okay. You are a dancer, correct?
Yes.
Could you tell us a little bit about that?
Well, I dance. I take ballet, tap, and jazz. And I dance in shows.
What's your favorite dance?
My favorite dance would probably be tap. I like
dancing?
Tap a lot, yeah. I have a real good teacher.
We've got the peanut gallery tapping.
Yeah. Go, Nate.
Okay, Nate. Thanks, buddy. When did you start dancing?
I started when I was three.
Three?
Yeah. And then I went through grade school, and I quit in about, second grade, and then I got in.
Why did you quit?
I just didn't like it. I didn't like going to practices or classes and stuff.
What made you join back up?
My mom.
Your mom?
Back up. I just missed it a lot. So
was your mom influential?
Yeah, she wanted me to start up again. So I started it up when I was a sophomore, and I'm still going. again.
Okay. Do you do shows or?
Yeah, I've been in a couple plays, and I dance in the shows, and I dance in musicals.
Dude, are you paid for these or are they on volunteer basis?
No, it's volunteer. Volunteer stuff, yeah.
With tryouts and all that funny stuff.
Marianne's come and saw a couple of my shows.
I was in a few, yes.
Two of them, yeah.
You were in them?
No, she came and saw them.
Oh, did you enjoy them?
I liked them. Oklahoma was the best. I liked on the bus.
But she had tickets to come and see My Fair Lady, but she missed it, that one.
Okay.
Yeah.
We have a clip.
Yes, we do.
Can you tell us a little bit about that clip?
In December, I was in Babes in Toyland, and I had a dancing part, and it was, it's supposed to be like a spider forest. I was a giant spider, and that's about it. And
do you dress up as a big giant spider?
Well, I'm in a leotard, and I'm, I've got glitter. I don't really look like a spider, but, well.
Okay, well, we're going to watch that segment.
Okay,
so
let's go.
All right, let's roll the segment. Naz Underground. We just had our little clip there, the dancing. It was very interesting.
Thank you.
Could you tell us about your dancing future?
I'm going to go to college next year and major in dance.
Okay.
Dance and dance performance.
You're hoping to dance for a living?
Yeah.
Like the big opera stuff or not opera, but you sing in the opera, right?
Yeah, you sing.
Just like the ballet.
Yeah.
Like, what's that famous guy's name? Tchaikovsky.
Briss.
No, Briss. Tchaikovsky. All right, well, what colleges are you? Wait, before you tell me the colleges, I guess, since we have a, we don't even have a peanut gallery today.
Yeah.
Well, we do kinda. All right, well, we're gonna break out the clap-o-meter and find out what college you're gonna go to. We're gonna decide on this show what college you go to, okay? All right, give me your first choice and no orders. Right off the top of your head.
Ball State.
Ball State?
Yeah,
all right. That's about, that's like a 10.
Three, but Karen, we all care.
That's like a, I'd say that's a 10.
Three,
all right, next one.
Three.
Next one.
Cal 3.
Western.
Western?
Illinois.
Western. No, no.
Yeah, all right. No one.
All right, we have 0.5. Next challenge.
Loras. Pardon me, Loras.
Who thinks she should go to Loras?
Yeah, all right, Loras. All right, go.
Looks like you're going to Ball State.
Nice.
Is that where you want to go?
Yeah.
That's like your main choice, your top choice?
My first choice, yeah.
Good.
Yep.
All right, Lily, thank you for having me on the show.
Thank you.
Hey, wait, are you going to sign a little paper so she can get out of college? Or is that only Matt Stafford?
My signature's not that right.
It is the Matt Powell show tonight. You might as well. I'm sorry, you have no writing.
Here, I'll just give him a call. Here. You call him up, and I'll talk to him. Go ahead and give him a call.
You're like bending over the counter, Matt. There's one right there.
I don't feel like bending by people anymore. All right, well, you gotta get him on the horn for me. I'm not gonna just talk. Are they on the phone? Are they there? Is this Ball State? This is Ball State. This is Matt Powell. Matt Powell. No, this isn't a prank call. Matt Powell from the Naz Underground. It's a public access show. What do you mean you've never seen it? Never heard of it. Hello? Hello? All right, maybe we'll just drop a note.
Okay.
All right. Well, thanks again for being on the show. And did you enjoy yourself?
Yes, I did.
That's good.
You're a good dancer.
Immensely.
Thank you.
Good dancer. That was a darn good segment. All right. Well, that's the end of our little thing here. And then, thank you. And then we're going to go to a commercial, and then we'll be right back.
Clear.
with the sacrament of confession, because the moment of communion is the highest and most sacred moment of your life. This is the moment when the living God enters your heart.
I really think that we should kick Stafford off the show. I think it should be just all my show.
I still don't believe that typhoon story. A typhoon. Okay, Matt. I think you're right. I think that it should be a show. It went good tonight. I thought it went good. I think it's because of you. And I think, yeah.
Well, naturally.
I think Matt Stafford should talk.
Hello. Matt, how you doing, buddy? Yeah. Well, how was that typhoon? Oh, really? Tell me about your trip. So, how you been lately?
I'm okay.
That's good.
I don't believe he has enough to come.
Yeah, I know. He's still rambling on.
So, how was that typhoon? Is he out of it now?
He says he's injured.
Oh, whatever.
Oh, that's great. That's great. Would you like to talk to Marianne? Oh, okay, here she is. Oh, that was good.
Oh,
that was
thanks. Good. Oh, thanks.
Oh.
I think you're right. No, definitely. Can we just...
Oh, jeez. Grand Central Station. Oh, and... No, Matt was on the phone. What are you doing?
Who is it?
Andy, the director.
Isn't he... He's right in the other room.
Yeah, why are you calling me? What? He said we're on. We're on. Places!
Should I kick this off?
hurry. We're on. Come on. Right now. Hi, welcome back to the Naz Underground. We're done now. This is the closing. And before we go, I'd like to thank another at-home viewer, Brian Schell, who's all gung-ho about, you know, big ad campaigns and all that. So we'll be talking to him later. All right, well, thanks for watching. Thanks for watching Naz Underground. See you later.
And of all my friends, you've been the best to me. Soon will be the day when I'll repay you handsomely. Broken hearts are hard to mend, nor had my share. But life just carries on. If I had my time again, I would do it all the same. And I'd change a single thing, even when I was the blame. For the heartache and the pain that I caused throughout my years. How I learned to be a man through the laughter and the tears. Situation no win. Rush for a change of atmosphere. I can't go on, so I give in. Gotta get myself right out of here.
This is insane. Hey, thank you. Welcome to Naz Underground. Now, I'm sorry, folks, we're going to have to get a little serious for a second here. Matt, would you like to tell them the topic of our show?
Well, you big peanuts, you, the topic of the show, very serious, serious problem in the United States, and that's bedwetting. And it needs to stop! It needs to stop! Come on!
Now, we're going to have a teenage sufferer of bedwetting, Mr. Smith. He should be here any... Oh, 1 second, I have a phone call. Hello?
Who could it be?
Oh, Mr. Smith.
Oh, no.
Embarrassed to show your face in public. Okay, I understand.
Oh.
All right, that's fine. Okay, yeah, you have a good day too. Well, Matt, who are we gonna have on the show today? Mr. Smith won't be here.
How about Steve Shepsky? Come on out here. Get out here. Bedwetter! Come on, stand right here. Tell us about your problem.
My problem? Well, I'm 16 years old. I've been wanting my bed for, 16 years.
Okay.
That's touching.
He was over with his problem.
Sit down now. Sit down. Okay. Thanks. Hey, we need a rag right about here.
All right. Beth Lubeck, come on up.
Come on. Bedwetter number two. Tell us.
Share your problem.
I'm a bedwetter too.
A bedwetter.
And I've been a bedwetter for my 15 years also.
Okay, 15 years.
Thank you. Very open. Give her a big round of applause. We've got Jason Walk. Jason, come on up. Share your problem.
Expose yourself.
Okay, not ready to share his feelings with the group yet, but that's okay. Okay, Dan Berger, come on up.
Get out of there!
The only way
get out of there!
To discuss it with the group.
Expose yourself! You gotta speak loud for us.
My mom gets mad.
Okay, always thinking of your family first, that's good. Okay, Brian Chubb, come on up.
I wasn't prepared for this.
Tell us about your problem.
I don't have a problem.
Denial's always
first stage. The first stage.
Okay.
Tom Sullivan. Tom Sullivan.
Not a teenager.
He has no problems. What about us?
Matt, tell them your problem. You see, Matt and I have fueled the effort to stop bedwetting because we're not only the presidents, but we're members of the association. And I've been wetting the bed as long as I can recall, waking up in just a pool. It's really terrible. But we are going to have more in-depth and interesting interviews with the bedwetters you've just met right after this.
You've taught your children to be polite and friendly, but have you taught them when not to be?
Hi there. Do you live around here?
Uh-huh.
You going to school?
Yes.
Well, I could give you a ride.
Last year, 50,000 children disappeared, many of them from nice, safe neighborhoods.
It's okay. Come on, help me.
Talk to your children about not talking to strangers, and do it today. A message for your child's safety from the American Medical Association.
Claymation artist Steve Shepsky and Beth Lebeck here. Now, you guys, what did you work on this project for?
Well, it's for our final grade.
In three dimensional.
Yeah, three-dimensional design.
These doggone rats, Beth. Karen, if you can hear me, call the exterminator. The rats are getting bigger every episode.
Hey, the water fell.
These rats are just a little bit crazy today.
Someone's got to clean that up.
That's enough.
We've got the broom. If someone would like to sweep that up for me. Now, how did Mrs. Garside choose students to do this final project?
I don't know. I think she chose the top five students in our class.
Six.
Or six, yeah. And worked on our final.
Peanuts.
So you are the best out of the Naz art class.
I guess. not really.
So modest. Now, how were you inspired or influenced to do this project?
Music.
YouTube. Yeah, music for YouTube. Well, first of all, we got a little meeting going. Okay, and then the first thing we did was choose music. So we chose Zoo Station by U2, and then we worked from there. We worked to the music.
Okay, well, so now we'd like to cut to the clip. This is the claymation that these two developed. We'll be back right after you see it.
The homeless problem.
Good looks and
die of violence.
Tiananmen Square today.
Up to the adults to teach the children.
Period. A pain reliever. The bullets.
Tempting as money.
Violent crimes are on the uprise.
So frustrating.
Mm-hmm.
fantastic. Now, what kind of work goes into preparing a final project?
Well, on this project, we spent 13 hours working on it, and took 200 or 250 different shots. So, took a lot of hard work. I know.
Karen, the rats.
I love you too.
Did you get an A?
Yeah, we got an A in this project too. Got an A plus.
Very nice rats.
Wow. Let's belong to one of the rats.
Die!
Okay.
Die, human!
Okay.
I'm alone now, but I'm not lonely. Oh, for a while I believed the myth that it's all downhill as you grow older. But now I know there are people who need me as much as I need them. Feeling alive is as simple as sharing the experience of a lifetime.
For your continuing good health from the American Medical Association.
Excellent.
Wow. Nice. Now we have with us Dan Berger and Brian Schell, two of the founding members of the now famous Jason Walk Fan Club. Now, I see you guys at the games cheering and dressing up for Jane, holding up posters. Now, what drives you to just go out and root for him every week?
I like Jay. Okay, well, I have a story to tell. The first time I met Jay was at the practice test at Nazareth Academy, and him and Steve Shefsky, who was on here earlier, they threw spitballs at me. And I just thought he was the coolest guy in the world, so I like him a lot now. And then we got into a fight, and now we love each other.
So he threw spitballs at you, you got in a fight with him, and now you're lovers?
Yes.
Woo!
I have a story also.
Go ahead.
Well, I met Jay a freshman year in Miss Bennett's religion class. And
I was also in the class.
Dan was also in there. Didn't care for him. Thought he was a smarty pants. And I just didn't get along with them. So one day we got in a fight because, you know, we had our differences. So we were talking about religion in this great class of Miss Benson's. And, you know, he was like goofing off and stuff. And I thought he wasn't really a good guy. And I didn't like him.
But you were wrong because he's a good
guy. But I was wrong. Now I love him. I do.
So the underlying theme is
I love
Jay.
Now, it obviously goes through its stages. Liking Jay starts off as
not liking him.
He's not a nice guy.
He's dirt.
Wait, who's Mrs. Bennett?
Mrs. Bennett is our wonderful religion teacher at Nazareth. She's very sexy and we're in our homeroom. She was our homeroom teacher freshman year. That was her first year, I think, wasn't it? Yes.
Censor.
What? She is.
Would you care to do that again for us?
Good, Jay.
You lovely individuals. I just want to eat you all up. Okay, I believe I left off at the I don't like Jay. He's a smarty pants stage.
But now I love him.
But I'm going in stages. Next was
my bad.
He's going somewhere with this.
Jay and I don't like each other. We're going to fight stage. And you both say you did fight with Jason Walk on an occasion?
We did.
He chased me with a stick.
Was there blood?
Around the park. No, he never caught me because I'm faster than he.
Okay.
I never went that deep with Jay, you know, just verbal argument.
Now, when was it that you realized, I don't hate Jay,
it's
I think he's
freshman year of basketball.
We really got to know the
we
guy.
We grew.
And we showered together, and it was just brought us together.
Better than Big
Sam. No, Jason did. That's why I like him.
Why are you laughing?
You're gonna cry.
Silly day. So it was just a little getting to know him. It wasn't a sudden
Oh, no.
No, it was a long journey. It was a gradual build-up.
Yes.
We realized how cute he was. Isn't he cute? Look at him.
Very cute.
He is cute.
Oh, that's a sailor hat.
So now, Steve. How have you gotten to know Jay more and more throughout the years?
Well, now we sit at his lunch table, and
he stuck gum on my back.
Oh,
my
by
chair.
The way,
oh, I have a story.
Table.
Little story.
Oh, okay.
You wanna? Right. Okay.
No, go ahead. I'll
tell we're eating lunch.
A bad Jay story or a good Jay story?
Depends how you want to look at it.
They're all good.
Yeah.
Okay.
We're sitting at lunch, you know, eating, and Jay throws gum on the chair, the back of the chair. Go to lean back, you know, as we all do. And I lean forward and a little restriction there. And I notice gum on my back. So everyone starts laughing. You know, I'm about to cry. And Jay said sorry. Because it was his gum and he spit it there. But
he didn't tell him.
I was mad.
It was kind of funny.
Yeah.
How recent was this?
The stain is still present on my shirt. Can't get it off.
We'll show it to you tomorrow.
2 weeks.
Wear that shirt tomorrow.
I'll wear
show
that shirt. Yellow shirt.
So this is a very recent
taste. Oh, yes. 2 weeks.
2 weeks ago, tops. Yeah. But as I was going to say, speaking of lunch, our third member, Chris Wedege, is also a member of the fan club, and he's very sick, and he couldn't make it today. You have a phone call.
Hello? Oh, Chris. Oh, yeah, hold on. Dan's right here. Dan's right here.
Oh. Hello? Oh, Chris, how you feeling, bud? Oh, yeah. He says hi. Oh,
tell him.
Okay.
The audience says hello.
He's, talk
to him.
He's feeling a little under the weather. Yeah, Jason's here. Yeah, he says hi. He loves you. Okay, he's sorry. Okay, here's Brad.
Hey, Chris. Under the weather? Yeah, I know how you
he's
mean.
Under the weather.
You know, I wish you could be down here, but, you know, we're here instead. Oh. So I'll let you go, and here's Matt.
Okay, well, Chris, thanks for calling. Oh, yeah, we know you love Jay. Don't worry.
Call waiting.
Call waiting. Second party.
Hold up. Hello? Another prank phone call.
Oh, I hate those guys.
Okay, well, Chris, we're going to let you go, but thank you very much for calling. Let's give a round of applause. Yeah. Okay, now you've gone through all the stages.
I like Jay.
You decided Jay is a pretty nice guy, but why, for just your everyday nice guy, would you go out to his games and just go so gung-ho about it, getting up, leading the chants?
Well, it's really not explainable. It's just a certain feeling you get.
Certain phenomena.
Yeah.
Yes.
I think if everybody got to know Jay, they'd feel the same way.
Yeah.
And we have a lot of prospective members to our group are on the waiting list and are eager
like
to join.
Like Dave Plowski.
Dave Plowski. Eric Miller. On the list.
We mentioned Chris Wedege.
Bill Sifferman.
Bill Siff.
No. So we're going to expand in the future.
Yes.
What game does he play?
What game does he
play? Basketball.
Have? Basketball.
Yeah.
Oh, neglecting the obvious. Jason is a basketball player.
You go, don't you?
He shoots the pumpkin.
The pumpkin. Inside joke.
What number is he?
Number 40. 40. 4-0. 4-0. 4-0. That's.
Did you really think that the fan club would not know Jason's number?
And what game he played? Jerky.
And how many points did you get last week?
Four points.
And 6 points, two games before that.
In the audience, if you would like to find out what Jay does, I found out this week in the Suburban Life since I was unable to
attend
the game.
Yes, his name was in the paper. Jason Walsh.
In the paper.
They spelled it right, too.
Spelled correctly and pronounced correctly, by the way.
Tim Walsh, by the way.
Tim Walsh?
His name is not Tim Walsh, it's Jason Walk.
Jason Walk.
Jason Walk, said with only the deepest and most sincere respect.
The L is silent.
Yes. We love Jay.
Now,
why doesn't he ever play?
Why don't you play?
Yay.
Team.
Why don't you try out?
Might be
Quite
good.
Maybe I'm neglecting the obvious, but he scored
four points last game. 6 points.
He's a player.
For that.
How many players are there that score points but never come out of the court?
He's pretty good.
Good cameraman.
Just sit down.
Why doesn't he start? Is that your question? Okay.
Next year.
Well, see, Mr. Richardson is he's campaigning for the sixth man award.
The basketball coach for varsity.
Yes, varsity basketball coach. Like, no, I believe it's the seventh man award that he's going for.
Or
the
sixth?
Eighth man award he's campaigning for. Because
I think it's a shoe-in for Jay.
Yeah, Jay's going to win.
Ninth man.
Jay will win.
So, hey, you're looking forward to seeing Jay in the starting spot next year.
Oh, next year he'll start.
Oh, sure. Yeah.
Okay, sounds good.
We'll protest if he does.
Yeah.
Okay, I think Jay's a great guy. And I've known Jay for our
longer. You can't argue with that.
Longer than us.
Now,
she went the bet.
What'd he say?
Excuse me.
Does he wet the bet?
You'll have to ask him.
You can ask Jay about wetting the bed later on. That's fine.
little break in the action.
Just a little lull. Okay, well, guys, I'd like to thank you just for showing everybody what a great guy Jay is.
Well, thanks for having us.
How much you love him. You guys are great.
Oh,
Jay's great.
Him.
And after this
I
commercial
like
break, we are going to have the man you've heard so much about, Jason Watt.
5 o'clock. People in a hurry, rushing for trains, for buses. Time to go home, to family. But for this man and 2 million like him, there is no hurry, no schedule, nowhere to go. For them, the street is home, their only home, the homeless. Just because you can't help everyone doesn't mean you can't help someone.
Second on the Chibidow. Outside
hey,
of Tuesday.
We're back to Naz Underground. We've still got Dan Berger of the Jason Walk Fan Club with us. A favorite here at Naz Underground. And now we've got the man you have heard so much about.
Walk, man.
Jason Walk. Basketball star extraordinaire from Nazareth Academy Roadrunners Varsity. Basketball.
Number 40.
40.
40-0.
Jay.
40-0.
Come on, guys. You had your chance to talk. Now we're going to hear the big man speak.
I didn't get enough.
You like Jay.
Well, you're not up here anymore. You can talk next week, Jerky.
I'll talk.
I don't have to talk to you, Jerky.
Jay, you've got quite a following. We just had these guys up here just professing their love for you. And they told me the stages of Jason Walk love. And I think I'm at the end. And I think I'm going to be joining the club pretty soon. But how does it feel to have all these people behind you at every game? Whether you're playing or on the bench, they're up there cheering for you.
Very grateful. Very, very grateful.
Now, can you vouch for the stories that
yes,
they found you to
yes.
be pompous and arrogant? And
yeah, they're true. They're true.
He could tell you, like, about our fight.
Right? Yeah. It was during the cross-country season.
Freshman
cross-country.
I provoked him, but...
Yes.
But I...
Damn, provoking. That's not
yes,
nice.
Yes, he initiated the contact.
Well, you pushed me. So I kicked him.
Kicked me in the midsection.
There was a real physical
yes.
contact.
And then he got a really big stick.
I didn't stick understand there. That from yeah. your story, Dan. You made it seem as if... Much like Bryant, it was a
verbal.
Verbal.
I told you he chased me with a stick.
But you never said he hit you. Nor did you say you kicked him in a certain region.
The abdomen.
The abdomen.
The lower.
Your poor abdomen. Your lower abdomen. Man, shame on you.
So sorry.
Now, Jay. Now, Jay, with your fan club members, did you perhaps go through the same stages with them that they did with you? Did you ever find Dan Berger to be pompous and arrogant and then
yes,
hit him?
Yes, that's why I chased him with the stick.
You never caught me, though.
Never caught you, though.
Now, how about with
Brian?
Brian Shaw.
I didn't have no
qualms.
No qualms with Mr. Brian Shaw,
BJ.
Mr. Shell,
BJ
Armstrong.
BJ.
So he hated you for
he hated me.
No reason.
Yes, he didn't know me.
I didn't know him.
Get to know me.
Jump to conclusion. Jay, you can take that with you. You can.
Thank you.
Get to know me.
Now, Jay, how have you been doing as a player for the basketball team?
I need the DJ.
All right. Pretty good. On the bench. Pretty well.
You got a good view of the game, though.
Right? Yeah, I got the best seat in the house. Okay. Best seat in the house.
Can you tell us how many points per game you're averaging right now?
About 2 or 3 points a game.
Two and a half, I'd say.
Which is not bad, especially when the fan club just goes wild whenever there is any scoring by this man right here. Now, Jay, I understand that while you are sitting on the bench or waiting to come out and lead the team to victory, your girlfriend is helping to lead the team to victory in her own special way as a Nazareth
pom-pom.
LJ.
Yes.
LJ.
I guess you can say that. Yes.
Okay, and Jay, I understand there are some special dates coming up. Your birthday, I believe.
Yes, Saturday, February 6th.
Happy birthday.
And I also understand there's an anniversary coming up from what I hear.
Yeah, 1 month anniversary with Leah tomorrow.
Leah.
Jay Shanker.
She's a senior.
Double congratulations.
Thank you.
Well, since you won't
and Mopsy.
Be on the
and
show.
My dog.
Oh, Mopsy.
And my dog, Mopsy.
Mopsy.
Saturday's his birthday.
Mopsy's a beautiful dog. Beautiful dog. Now, Jay, since you won't be with us on your birthday,
mm-hmm.
we're going to sing happy birthday to you right now.
Oh, you should.
Okay, everybody, a one, a two, a three.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Jason Wong.
Wow.
Happy birthday to you.
Oh, thanks. Thanks.
Oh, Jason.
Thanks, guys.
Now, Jay,
mm-hmm.
next season, sure the fan club is still going to be going. I know I'm going to stop by to see you when I'm not off on special missions and such.
Like Mormon mission?
When I'm not spreading the word of God.
The Baha'i faith.
I know. Don't knock it
until you try it.
Take it to your
solid.
That's solid.
Now, Jay, next season, what kind of position do you see yourself as playing for the team next year?
Position? A role player.
So you think you're going to be a real anchor for that team?
Yes, I hope so.
Now,
hopefully.
How do you feel about the fan club sticking with you through next season?
We'll be there.
Oh, hopefully. There. I hope so.
Does it inspire you to play a little
yes,
better?
Yes, it does. Yes,
hear
it
them
does.
Up in the stands just yes, going wild? That's great. Now, I would like a big round of applause first for the fan club. And then for the man himself, Jason Wong.
Thank you.
And Jay, I'd like to thank you so much for
being
here.
Thanks for letting me on the show.
And Brian.
Steve.
We'll be back for our conclusion right after this.
You're listening to singer-songwriter Danny Dierdorf, one of many people who prove that the reality of man is his spirit.
Birds fly over the rainbow. Why then, oh why?
A public service of the Baha'i Faith.
Well, that brings us to the close of yet another ever-interesting episode of Naz Underground. We'd like to thank Steve Shepsky and Beth Lubeck, everyone. We'd like to thank the Jason Walk Fan Club, Ryan Schell and Dan Berger, and Chris Wedeke, who couldn't be here. And we'd like to thank Jason Walk himself. We hope you enjoyed the show. Would you like to say anything, Matt, or would you like to just jam?
Just jam, man.
You keep going. All right, we'll see you next week.
And of all my friends, you've been the best to me. Soon will be the day when I'll repay you handsomely. Broken hearts are hard to mend, nor had my share. But like if I had my time again, I would do it all the same. And I'd change a single thing, even when I was the blind. For the heartache and the pain that I caused throughout my years, how I learned to be a man through the laughter and the tears. Situation no end, rush for a change of atmosphere. I conquer one so I give in, gotta get myself right out of here.
Well, thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Naz Underground. I'm Matt Stafford.
And I'm Matt Powell.
And today on the show, we have Trisha Harris and Elise Murphy,
who are going to display some of their theatrical abilities.
And the juggling mastermind, Brian Shell.
And we'll be back right after this. Trisha Harris and Alish Murphy, who are going to perform a poem that they wrote themselves. Here they are.
Sve und I. Prom is coming.
Prom is coming.
Prom is coming.
Australia is for kangaroos.
Oshkosh is for cheeseheads.
Daytona is for sunburns.
Chicago is where it's at.
Is it, love?
I don't know.
Time will tell.
What do you get when you mix satin sheets with silk pajamas?
Sex on the floor.
My jeans are wet with foreign beer and
vodka.
Don't distract me. I'm making white sauce. Okay? Okay?
Come on.
Basketball in the face.
I have a nosebleed.
The bitch is unloading the dishwasher.
Chewing tobacco.
Chewing tobacco.
You can't use it.
I won't call.
But I made it girl size.
These girls are not Swedish.
Marquette.
To Northwestern.
To Loyola.
Who cares?
We're going to rape you.
What did you do?
We played basketball.
A kiss on the cheek.
A peck on the lips.
A little bit of tongue.
Smack, smack.
Drip, drip.
Is there a leak?
Norwegian pasta.
We made a meal.
Why do you say papa?
Papa means daddy.
I'm trapped in the North Park prison.
Knullkungen.
Cell 313.
Intellectual.
Stimulating.
Conversation.
Is that an Irish accent?
Depends on who's asking.
I am.
Children. Become adults.
We're not who we say we are.
Do you mind?
Do you care?
Soccer affects one's sexual aggression.
Much too passive.
But once the engine started,
mother calls.
I cannot stay. My sister ice skates.
We'll call a cab.
She's 14.
Do you kiss?
Thump, the man hits the floor.
That was cool.
Back to bed.
You're so goofy.
Is that good?
We got busted.
Was it worth it?
I think so.
Thank you.
Why are you gonna rape me?
Well, I don't know if anybody else is wondering this same question as I am, but could you tell me a little bit about the meaning of the poem?
Actually, we've made a vow not to divulge any, or, well, most of the poem's meaning.
However, it does have a common theme.
Yeah, it's not just words. It has a meaning to it.
Explain. I noticed.
Explain why.
Sexual sex, drip drip, rape. Am I getting the common theme?
No.
No.
What about white cream?
That has no sexual meaning.
That's no sexual meaning whatsoever.
Well, explain. Sure.
And it's white sauce.
Yes.
Tell us what it means, Satan.
Now, we have white sauce, drip drip, sex, sexual rape.
Yeah. We're going to rape you.
Why? But we still don't have the right theme here.
No, you don't. You have
the theme
to look
is in the
title.
Okay. Now, is this poem based on personal experience?
Yeah,
you could say that. Yes.
Wow.
I could say that,
what?
Or it is based on personal experience.
Yes, it is.
Yeah, most of it.
I would really like to know where the white cream or white sauce?
White sauce.
White sauce.
The white sauce, the dripping, the sex, sexual, and rape. How can the theme not be what I'm thinking that the theme is?
Pervert.
Pick one and we'll tell
you.
Yeah, you
guys can pick one
meaning.
And we'll tell you the meaning.
Here's a. If you
okay, go.
Pick one and we'll tell you.
Well, there's the obvious satin sheets and silk PJ, sex on the floor.
Mm-hmm.
I do understand that one.
Okay.
Okay.
Yes.
Here's one that I don't quite understand. This is not the sexual theme that I think I noticed.
Okay.
I'm trapped in the North Park prison.
Oh no.
Kunal Kungan, cell 313.
Well, okay.
You've been in prison?
No.
Just go ahead. Explain.
Well, the subjects of the poem go to North Park College and they call it a prison.
They hate it.
And they hate it. And Kunal Kungan means king of beer, and cell 313 is their
room.
Their
number.
Room.
Is that German?
No, it's Norwegian.
Yeah, it's Norwegian.
What did you say in the beginning? You're like, was that German? The
what?
First line?
Sven and I? No. No, those are the names. Shortened versions of the names.
Of what names?
We can say it. Sven and Eirik.
Sven?
Who are they?
Our boyfriends.
In Germany?
No, Norway.
They're exchange students at North Park College.
Woo.
Yep.
Have they heard this?
Well, I guess
No.
Dripping white sauce. I will
sex
send them a copy.
The
oh, will you?
Do they know what you're telling people?
Well, I think we'll just drop any sexual connotation.
It's not sexual, really. It's not.
Then explain it.
No, it's...
It's none of your business, Mr. Powell. It's none of your business, Mr. Powell.
Then they shouldn't have read it.
I don't know.
Oh, we were asked to.
Yeah.
Well, you should have said
now we will move on from the poem.
Okay,
now you're going to perform a skit for us. Now, what is the skit about?
It's called Boy Meets Girl. It's from the play Free to Be You and Me. And it's about two babies. I mean, we play two babies. And we're fighting over which one's the boy and which one's the girl.
Oh, hello, obvious,
though. No, because they're babies.
Do your eyes function properly?
Yeah.
Mind your own business, Mr. Powell, please.
Yes, Captain.
Okay. Now, can you tell us, what other ways are you involved in acting?
Actually, both of us are involved in the Nazareth Academy production of Oklahoma.
And your roles?
We're both in chorus and dancers. I was also in Our Town at the beginning of the year I play the part of Mrs. Webb, and why are they all waving at me?
Ignore that.
Okay. I've always been involved in acting since like second grade, so it's pretty much a big part
what
of my
did you
life.
Do in second grade?
Actually, the first play I was in The Wizard of Oz, and I was the head munchkin. I think so.
Now, where do each of you plan on going to college?
Well, for me, it's a toss-up between University of Wisconsin at Madison and Indiana University.
Okay.